John H. Nelson was an electrical engineer working for Radio Corporation of America in the 1950s. As part of his research, he built a rooftop observatory in Manhattan for making astronomical observations. He wanted to see if there was some correlation between shortwave radio propagation conditions on Earth and solar conditions. The aim was to find a way to improve signal broadcast quality. What he found was rather startling. After making many observations, he discovered that when certain angles between planets occur, they seem to correspond with significantly reduced radio wave propagation across the Earth. What is incredibly fascinating is that the planetary angles which cause this effect, 0 degrees, 90 degrees, 180 degrees, known as conjunct, square, and opposition, have been studied for thousands of years by astronomers and have been found to cause warfare, revolutions, economic collapse, and new kingdoms to appear. These are known as the hard aspects. A mechanism for this may be that the Sun is highly affected by these hard planetary aspects and shuts down some of its ultraviolet light energy propagation. This would result in a shortening of the growing season and crop failure. More expensive primary products like grain would slow down economies and collapse others. It was William Herschel in 1801 who reported the correlation between sunspots and commodity prices. More sunspots result in reduced prices and a greater abundance of healthier plants, and vice versa. In bad years, an entire wine crop might be spoiled. Food fails to develop on the vine, or dies of frost, and famine results. This is more than enough to bring down many a nation's economy. All economies are built from the bottom up, so a fundamental change in agriculture can have wide-ranging effects upon stock markets. In Nelson's case, a stronger solar field in the absence of right-angle hard aspects seemed to enhance shortwave signal quality. This might be because the solar wind helped to create a more energized and therefore reflective magnetosphere for signals to bounce off from. There are many potential explanations. Nelson found that the best conditions occurred under trine, or planets staggered at 120 degrees. This is called a soft aspect. This is just the scenario which ancient astrologers and even some more recent notables, including Tycho Brahe and Johannes Kepler, advocated as facilitating good conditions on Earth. Nelson published his work in the journal Electrical Engineering, and there is a link section below for anyone who would like to read it. Is it a coincidence that Nelson's work seems to support the teachings of the ancients, which were based upon observation and deduction? Did Nelson imagine his findings? There has been much research done in the area, but I came across a website containing an article by David Dalton, who appears to have utilized Nelson's prediction approach, which Nelson himself claimed was between 85 and 90% accurate for predicting signal propagation quality. The results appear to support Nelson's findings, and a link is provided below. Nelson himself did not advance any particular theory to explain his observation. He had no agenda to push and did not fancy himself an astrologer. Nevertheless, his work seems to support in principle the fact that what were once known as hard planetary aspects have a tangible effect upon what the Sun does to the Earth. His observations support the idea that changing planetary angles have a strong effect upon the Sun.